So I am the director of programming for the Maine Film Center, which means Railroad Square Cinema and the Maine International Film Festival. And really all I want to do tonight is share with you some of my favorites, not all of my favorites, from among the 103, I think is the count, films at this year's Maine International Film Festival. So this year's festival is dedicated to Jonathan Demme, a past guest of ours who a lot of you have known. He came up twice and he was going to come back this year, but as you probably know, he passed in April, a tremendous loss to all of us, and so we're dedicating the festival to him. This is Stop Making Sense, simply the best concert movie ever, and I expect you all to come out and dance because that's the only thing to do. This is something wild. I think it's one of the great American movies of all time, and it's not really recognized as that, but I think it will be eventually. We're showing a 35mm print of that. It's a total gas, and I have always loved this film. It's kind of a marriage of a rom-com and a thriller, and if you don't think that goes together, you will after you see this. This is our Midlife Achievement Award winner, Lauren Hutton, who is known both as a model and an actress. This is a still from her film with Robert Altman, A Wedding. If Jonathan Demme was my role model as a human being in life, Robert Altman is my idea of a god of a director. And so A Wedding is going to be fun to see with Lauren in it. Here's Keith Carradine. The two films that you saw were A Wedding. This is by Altman's disciple, Alan Rudolph, and Lauren is in that film as well. That's Keith Carradine, a past guest of ours. They both use ensemble casts, and it's one of the things that they have in common, among many others. Besides Welcome to L.A., we have another L.A. set film. This is Double Indemnity with Fred McMurray and the sublime, sublime, sublime Barbara Stanwyck. A fantastic film by Billy Wilder. If you've never seen it and never seen a film noir, this is it. And we have a lovely 35mm print of that. We have a Restoration of Sunrise. This is a still from that. It's the first Academy Award winner and was also the first Academy Award winner for cinematography. We have cinematographer Roger Deakins being honored with an award this year for named after the guy who won that cinematography award, Carl Struss. Here is Ugetsu, the fantastic film by Kenji Mizoguchi, absolutely one of the five most amazing film directors of all time. Ugetsu is an absolutely haunting ghost story, and we have a new DCP restoration of that that we're sharing with you this year. This is Le Cercle Rouge, fantastic French film by Jean-Pierre Melville. It's a kind of bank heist, tough guy movie, as all of his movies are. This is, I think, his greatest film and one of his last ones, restoration of this fantastic film as well, one of the highlights. There are a lot of revivals and restorations because it's a chance to show these films. And if you love seeing those films, here's one for you. This is Decalogue by Krzysztof Kieślowski, who made Red, White, Blue, The Double Life of Veronique, another one of the greatest directors ever. Decalogue is in 10 parts, 1 hour each. You don't have to see any two parts together. It's not one story, although they do interact. Fantastic film. Stalker, legendary kind of science fiction film by Andrei Tarkovsky, also in a restoration. There's an image from it, and it gives you kind of an idea of the kind of power of the imagery. Tarkovsky only made 7 movies in his life, and many, many people consider Stalker the greatest. Here's an incredibly memorable image from Down in Shadowland, which is a documentary made by a handheld camera by Tom DeSillo, another one of our special guests at the festival. This is his most recent film, and it sort of marks the transition from the older films to the newer films here. Tom will be here with 3 of his earlier films. Here is a film from Argentina and New York simultaneously. This is called, blah, blah, my brain is now going. This film is called Nobody's Watching, and it's by Julia Solomonov, who will be joining us. And this is about a guy caught between those two worlds. Here's another Argentinian film called Natural History, which shows you, despite this ship, the beauty of Argentina's just landscape, even though it's best known for Buenos Aires, where Karen and I live for several months of the year, every year now. This, on the other hand, is from the landscape of Baltimore, Maryland. It's from a film called Rat Film, and it is about rats, and it is utterly fascinating, utterly idiosyncratic, and quite remarkable in its own way. A documentary, but nobody's going to be saying, here are 47 rats. It's not like that. Here's another animal film. This is called The Last Pig. It's about a pig farmer who loves his pigs, and after having done this for a while, can't kill them anymore. I'm a vegetarian. But I think it's a great film anyway, even if you're not. The director and producer of that will be here as well. Here's one of my favorite new films. This is called Axolotl Overkill. It's directed by a woman named Helena Hegeman, who is now 25 years old. She just directed this film. It's based on her novel that she wrote when she was 17, which became a bestseller in Germany. And it is as wild and energetic as any film you've ever seen. Here is Skye Bergman and her 104, maybe a couple years less than that at the time of this shot, grandmother from Skye's film Lives Well Lived. Skye is here tonight and will be here with the film as well. It's about people on in years who don't live like they're on in years, have just huge amounts of energy, and it's a wonderful film. Here is a world premiere film that we're having this year from a favorite filmmaker of mine from Idaho, who will be with us as well, Rob White here. It's called The Ecology of Jazz, and it's about jazz. That's Azar Lawrence, one of the great tenor saxophone players ever. And nature. What does jazz have to do with nature? You didn't think it had anything to do with it, did you? But you will find out otherwise here. This is our closing night film, Rumble, and it is another music film. It's about rock and roll and Native Americans. And wow, it's much, much closer than you ever imagined. And the film is a gas, and the subject is a gas. And see you all at the movies. Thank you.